As a UX practitioner, you might be aware of several cognitive biases that affect how users interact with our designs. But did you know that there are several biases that we commonly fall victim to as well, that affect how we go about making our design decisions? Common biases affecting our UX practice include the overconfidence effect, framing, and the status quo bias. The overconfidence effect is the tendency to overestimate your knowledge and abilities. And this actually gets worse the more expert you become. We tend to place excessive confidence in our own answers to questions. But sadly, things that we're 99% certain about turn out to be wrong 40% of the time. This is why it's dangerous to go with our gut for designing, or assuming we can skip usability testing because this is obviously the best way to design this. Make sure your design decisions are rooted in research and data, and not your ego. The framing bias causes us to draw different conclusions from the same information based on whether that information was framed as a negative or a positive. For instance, if we hear that 4 out of 10 users failed to complete a task in a usability study, we'd be tempted to redesign that workflow. On the other hand, hearing that 6 out of 10 users succeeded, we're more likely to believe we can leave things as they are. But those are the same rates. Lastly, the status quo bias refers to our tendency to resist change, our desire to maintain that status quo. This is related to loss aversion, as we're afraid to lose or change what we already have. So in design, this results in hesitation to remove features from an interface, even ones that turn out to not be adding much to the user experience. Make sure there's a reason something continues to exist in your designs other than that's the way it's always been. To avoid these three biases and make sound design decisions, test your assumptions rather than relying solely on your expertise. Consider both sides of the data rather than focusing only on the good or the bad. And don't be afraid to question the status quo. There's always room for improvement in our designs, even if it means getting rid of something that only used to work well.